Morning to one and all. My name is Aryan Kiran, and today I am going to explain you about the topic in applied physics, that is de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron. Now let us discuss in detail what is de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron. Before going to the topic de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron, it is very important for us to know what is wave and particle duality of radiation. Now let us discuss what is wave and particle duality of radiation. A particle has mass. It is located at some definite point. It can be from one place to another. It gives energy when slowed down or stopped. Thus, the particle is specified by its mass, velocity, momentum, and energy. Here we can know that a particle is specified by its mass, velocity, momentum, and its energy. A wave. Now let us discuss what is a wave. A wave is spread out over a relatively large region of space. It cannot be said that to be located just here and there. It is hard to think of mass being associated with a wave. Actually, a wave is nothing but a rather spread out disturbance. A wave is specified by its frequency, wavelength, phase of wave, velocity, amplitude, and its intensity. Now let us discuss what is de Broglie hypothesis. To understand better de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron, it is very important for us to know de Broglie hypothesis. Now let us discuss it. In quantum mechanics, matter is believed to behave both like a particle and a wave at the submicroscopic level. As we discussed what is a particle and a wave, we will further know about it. The particle behavior of matter is obvious. When you look at the table, you think of it like a solid stationary piece of matter with a fixed location. At this macroscopic scale, this holds true. But when we zoom into the subatomic level, things begin to get more complicated and matter doesn't always exhibit the particle behavior that we expect. This non-particle behavior of matter was first proposed in 1923 by Louis de Broglie, a French physicist. In his PhD, he proposed that particles also have wave-like properties. Although he did not have the ability to test this hypothesis at the time, he derived an equation using Albert Einstein's famous mass-energy relation and Planck's equation. Albert Einstein's famous mass-energy equation is E is equal to m square. This, where these waves associated with particles are named as de Broglie waves or matter waves. Now let us come to the main topic of this session, that is expression for de Broglie wavelength. The expression of wavelength associated with a matter material particle can be derived on the analogy of radiation as follows. Considering the Planck's theory of radiation, the energy of photon can be given as E is equal to h into nu, where nu is equal to c by lambda. So from that, energy of photon can be said as E is equal to hc by lambda, where c is the velocity of light in vacuum and lambda is its wavelength. According to Einstein, mass energy relation can be known E is equal to mc square. So equalizing both of them, E is equal to h by mc, that is equal to h by p, where mc is equal to p is momentum associated with photon. If we consider the case of material particle of mass m and moving with a velocity v, that is momentum mv, then the wavelength associated with this particle in analogy to wavelength associated with the photon is given by lambda is equal to h by mv, that is equal to h by p. Now let us discuss what is different expressions for de Broglie wavelength. If E is the kinetic energy of the material particle, then E is equal to half mv square, that is equal to half m square v square by m, that is equal to p square by m. P square is equal to 2me, or P, you know that P is equal to under root 2me. Therefore, de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h by under root 2me. When a charged particle carrying charge Q is accelerated by a potential difference V, then its kinetic energy Ke is given by E is equal to QV into V. Hence, the de Broglie wavelength associated with a particle is lambda is equal to h by under root 2mQV. As we know that charge of electron is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 and mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 13. When we substitute this formula in the above equation, that is lambda is equal to h by under 2 mqv, we get when we substitute those all those values, that is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 by under root 2 into 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 into charge of electron, that is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19, we get the value as under root 1 by 150 by V, where V is the potential, where V is the potential difference, where V is the potential difference V, which is applied on the charge, accelerated through the charge. Now let us discuss a basic problem, which is on the de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron. That is, in the question, it is given calculate the velocity and kinetic energy of an electron of wavelength 0.21 nanometers. So basically, in this problem, wavelength is given, wavelength 0.21 nanometers is given. Solution, de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h by mv. V is equal to h by m lambda. That is, from this we get nu has 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 by 9.31 into 2.1 into 10 to the power minus 10. So equalizing all those, substituting all those values, we get the new value as 34.67 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second. Now, as we get the velocity value, we substitute that value in the to get kinetic energy. As we know, the formula of kinetic energy, E is equal to half mv square. We substitute the mass in that velocity, as we got 34.67 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second, and we substitute the mass, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. So by this we get kinetic energy as 0.5469 into 10 to the power minus 17 joules. From this, we have to convert the kinetic energy in terms of electron volts. We can achieve that by dividing the kinetic energy, which is in joules, with 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So we get 341.82 electron volts, as shown in the slide. Now let us discuss another problem, which is here it has been asked to find the wavelength of the proton moving with a velocity 1 by 10 of velocity of light. So basically, here the velocity of light is given. So from this, as we know that de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h by mv. Lambda is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. H is the Planck's constant, that is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. As we know that mass of proton is 1.674 into 10 to the power minus 21, minus 27, sorry, as the velocity is given by 1 by 10 of velocity of light. Velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8. So 1 by 10 of 3 into 10 to the power 8. So substituting all those values, we get de Broglie wavelength lambda has 1.31 into 10 to the power minus 14 meter per second. So basically, from all these slides, we came to know that we learned what is wave and particle duality of radiation, and after that we discussed what is wave in detail and how it is specified and how a particle is also specified, and after that we learned de Broglie hypothesis, and after that we learned what the main topic, that is de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron, that is lambda is equal to h by p, where p is the momentum, and we have done some problem. So with this, I will stop this. Thank you.